Hey guys, welcome back to Waron Mechanics. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. Today will be super helpful video to any of you guys having a Jeep Compass or Jeep Renegade. You have engine light on and you guys have any of the following four codes. I'm talking about code P0301, P0302, P0303 or code P0304. We will explain what causes each of these codes and how to fix it, guys. We'll share the top, I think, five most popular reason that we see here at the shop that caused that code, guys. As you can see, the engine is out of the car. Why? Pretty simple. We did an engine replacement and we made, guys, more than 100 videos with the engine out, how to fix different components, pretty much anything on that engine. Because being out, we can show you how to do things. If it's in the vehicle, it's practically impossible because this is a little complicated engine, guys. It has a independent variable timing on each cylinder as well, guys. So it's very, very complicated, little and efficient engine. Now, before we continue, guys, why we make so many videos? It's pretty simple. Our mission at the shop is to save you as much money as we can. All we need, guys, in return, please subscribe to the channel and like the video so we can keep providing that free information. If you need to buy any of the replacement parts, tools, the scanner that we're using here, and we'll talk about that, we'll have the link shared in the description of the video below, so please check it out. We post that for your convenience, guys. So, these codes, they indicate engine misfire. And usually, guys, okay, this is the computer that we use to scan the system. This is the one that we use the most. Okay, we use quite a few computers here at the shop, but this is the one that we use the most. So, this computer, guys, what I like about it, it works on pretty much any car you can think of. One cool thing about that computer, guys, okay, it's the fact that it works on American vehicles, European vehicles. Check out, you have three pages of European cars and Asian vehicles, and we use that all the time. Things I like about it, top five things, they release updates all the time, guys. So you get new functions, new vehicle models and new things added all the time. Number two, guys, you can access every computer in your car. Number three, you can read codes in every computer. Number four, you can delete codes from every computer. And number five, you can see live data for every system. So that's very helpful when you're diagnosing the system. And here is the engine, guys. If you have a Jeep Compass, you will notice that your intake boot may be a little bit shorter than that because that's from Renegade, but it's practically the same. And your engine cover will be actually black. We painted ours white because we like the way it looks, guys. So now, with that being said, okay, it attaches, that engine cover attaches to these four posts right here. So all you have to do, just grab it with two hands and pull it straight up and it will come out. And I want to show you now, guys, I'm going to remove the intake air duct right here. Okay, I have everything pre-loosened, not to waste your time, but this is the top of your engine. Okay, that's what it looks like, guys. This is your the top of your engine. So now let me explain what we have here. Ignition coils right here. Under the ignition coils, we have spark plugs. Fuel injectors are on the back side. Variable timing right here. The top five things that we see, guys, for misfires. Number one, spark plugs that are worn, okay? The wrong type of spark plugs, or spark plugs that are defective, guys. Okay, check your spark plug, check the gap, and make sure that you have the correct type of spark plug and the correct brand. Okay, I'll put the link in the description of the video below for the spark plugs that work really good in our vehicle, and I love them because in the past I used the fuel efficient spark plugs and they were giving me quite a bit of trouble. Number two, guys, if it's not spark plugs, you may have a faulty ignition coil. And you start counting, okay? Code P0301 will be for cylinder number one. This one will be on the very left side facing the engine towards the oil cap. Cylinder number two, okay, you have code P0302. Code P0303 will be for cylinder number 3, and P0304 is for cylinder number 4. So the last digit of the code corresponds to the cylinder number. So you checked spark plugs, you checked ignition coil, you still get that code. What it could be, guys, it could be a dirty fuel injector. Or a fuel injector that doesn't work correctly, guys. If you have a fuel injector that's not spraying enough fuel, or if it's clogged, if it's dirty, okay, that can cause, guys, okay, to get that code as well. It happened in the past, so that's reason number three. Now, reason number four, guys, it could be low fuel pressure, which could be caused by bad, weak fuel pump or clogged fuel filter. This is very common, guys. And reason number five that we see quite often, okay, it's actually vacuum leak. Vacuum leak is any extra air that the engine takes, but he doesn't know about that there. And check your PCV valve. It's a known component that can cause that as well. Bad PCV valve that's stuck open can cause that. We have the video on the channel how to test them as well. Those are the top 5 things, guys. Of course, it could be another probably 5, but 94% of the time that will fix code P0301, 303, 2, 3, and 4. So hopefully, guys, video will be helpful. Thank you for watching and see you guys next time.